Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, may we ask that those in attendance please rise and kindly remove your hats. Active duty or retired military may keep their hats on while rendering the military salute. For the singing of the Star Spangled Banner, please welcome singer, songwriter, and actress, Detroit native Beth.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, all the we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? Oh, the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Are you ready?
And on this Martin Luther King Day, good afternoon, Red Wing fans from Little Caesars Arena. The Blue Jackets and the Red Wings, first of eight meetings this season. Columbus 0-2 on the road to start, with a couple of losses in Nashville, 3-1 and 5-2. Our Southeast Michigan Metro Detroit Ford dealers, there's Jonas Corposello, who is 4-0 against Detroit. He played opening night, gave up just 2 on 34. In Nashville for the Blue Jackets. The Red Wings go back to Thomas Greiss, who played well opening night, but the Wings couldn't get him any goal support. And Jeff Blasher wants both goalies to play until one perhaps takes over. Justin St. Pierre, Garrett Rank, they're the referees, and the Red Wings begin with Matthias Brome, Luke Glendening, and Franz Nielsen up front. Nielsen in for Adam Ernie, who's out with COVID protocol, and Nielsen gets the shot on goal after sitting game two and playing game one, forces Corposello to make the first save of this afternoon.